Okay, so I just, you know, took a good peek at the burner sections here, and just to make sure that I didn't see any obvious cracks or any problems. I wasn't expecting any, but as long as you got it opened up, I think it's a good idea to just kind of look in there and check. I did have one. My shop heater actually developed a crack in one of these combustion areas, and had to replace it because there's essentially no repair for that. But so I like to look at them, you know, when I get it opened up. All right, guys, I'm going to check out the ohm windings in this motor. And want you to check out a video by a guy named 21 Foot Express. I'll put the link in the description. Certainly giving him all the credit for this, and he explains all this in pretty good detail. But what he suggests is when you go to check your motor, that you draw it out the same way he draws his. So I'm going to do this. I'm going to do that. So what we've got here is one terminal called the common terminal, for C for now, and it's got some windings coming out of there, probably some resistance, and this is the S terminal. There's a line coming out of there. There's another set of windings, because an AC motor won't start itself unless you have a separate set of windings. And this is called the, this is the R, or run terminal. This is the start terminal. I hope you guys can see that. Okay, and then there's a brown wire coming out of here, and it leads to a start capacitor, which is in line. Okay, this is another brown wire, sometimes brown with a white stripe. The color on this terminal is white, and as he says in his video, if you only had one speed, this would be the high speed, and it would be black. But since it's multiple speeds, and again, I'm moving through this fairly quickly because he covers it in very good detail. This is the blue, or green in my case, and this is for medium high. And in my motor, it's being used for the cool side of the board. So when the air conditioner calls for ventilation, it turns on this line, not this line. So this is heat. This is cool. It should be another resistor right in here, and this line would be yellow, and it would be medium low, and then there would be another resistor up here to another line, and this would be red, and this would be low. Okay, so that's essentially what I've got in my motor, and the data plate on my motor shows that. I don't know if you guys can see that, but there's a schematic right on my motor that shows that. So, but I also know from seeing the schematic on the system that's what these wires do. Okay, so what I want to do to ohm out the meter is, the first thing you want to do, set your meter obviously to ohms, and then I want to take and make sure that, here's my ground strap, make sure that I have no shorts from any of these wires, in this case I'm doing black, to the case or to ground. And I'll put it on beep here, and I should hear, let's see if I can, no beeping. I don't have a clamp to make this a lot easier. So I'm going to go through all my wires here, make sure that I don't have anything going to ground, and I do not. Do the yellow one again, or let's get the yellow one, and let's do the yellow one just to be sure. But I've done these already, and I didn't get anything. Okay, so the next, so there's no shorts. The next thing I'm going to do is measure resistances. So I'm going to go from white to black. So now I go back to the ohm scale. White to black, 3.0. From black then to blue, and I'm just going to go right up this scale here, 1.3. So you see that they don't put a very big resistor in between the black and the blue for the air conditioner or the heat. They essentially run them at about the same speed, although the air conditioner runs a little slower. Then we go from blue to yellow. Again, 1.3. Then we go from yellow to red. And we get 3.6. Now if we go from red to black, now we should have somewhere around, that's 2.6, 5.6, 6.2. We get 6.0. So, yeah, it's close enough. And then I want to go check this winding now and check from black to the start terminal, which is one of the brown leads. There's two brown leads, and there's 39.9 ohms, and then if I go from white to the other brown, and I, since they're both the same color brown, I marked one, so I know that it's on this side. It's 8.9. So there's actually a resistor from this point, you know, to this point. So let's just draw it in here. And it's 8.9. Okay. And so that quickly, you've checked the winding on the motor and determine that that there are no shorts to ground, there are no opens in any of these lines, because instead of getting a resistance value, you'd get zero, or open line, what it's showing right there, OL, or infinite resistance. And these values will vary depending on your motor, but they should be, this is representative of what some of those should be. Just, you know, to see. I pulled off some values off the internet. Somebody's asking questions, and they're not anywhere near what mine are. But you know, they're from white to black. It's 6 ohms. I'm double that. Sorry, I'm half that. From white to blue. White to blue. It's 9. I would be about 4.3, so I'm half that again. From white to red, I would be all this. It'd be 3 plus 6, it'd be about 9. And they are 15. Again, a little over half. And I'm not sure that these values really are that important, because it's going to depend on the way your motor is wired, the size of the windings, the type of resistor that they've got in there. That's going to change things up. So I'm not going to get too concerned, but in my opinion, this motor now will run. I've checked it, and I will put the new capacitor on, and we will get we'll fire up this motor again. I've cleaned it up, taken some compressed air and just a rag right there, and just wiped it down, and so it's clean and ready to go. I've also cleaned the, I've also washed and degreased all the squirrel cage blower and the housing, all turned out real nice and clean, all clean inside, and ready to get put in. All right, stay tuned. Okay, I know this looks busy, but it's really not too bad. It's the same diagram. I just finished up taking a couple other readings. I didn't want to bore you with it, but I wrote down all the totals of those readings. And basically, on that same video by 21 Foot Express, he mentions that taking readings from one wire to another is basically the sum of each individual segment. Now that you've ohmed out the resistance for each individual segment, you can see that it makes sense now. If you take a measurement, for instance, from red to black, you should get the sum of each of these segments. So in this case, from red to black, we would be looking for 6.2. That'd be the sum of these three. And what I actually got was 6.0, which is close enough. That's right in the ballpark. That's what we're looking for. If you were to measure from yellow to blue, yellow to blue is 1.3, but yellow to black would be 2.6. It should be somewhere around that number right there, the sum of these two. From red to white would be the sum of all of these numbers here coming this way, and in my case that adds up to 9.2. That's what I was looking for. I got 8.8, very close. And you can see I did, you know, of course, here's brown. So brown to black was 39.9. So if I went brown to blue, I'd be looking for 41.2. Let me go turn the camera this way. I'd be looking for 41.2. I got 41.1. From brown to yellow, I'd be looking for 42.5. Got 42.4. And from brown to red, I'd be looking for 46.1. I got 45.8. Very close. So I'm happy with that, with all those readings. It all makes sense. They all add up. There's no reason why this motor shouldn't work. And it spins freely, so the bearings aren't shot on it. So we're going to throw that motor back on. Now we're going to look at the capacitor. Here's the old one and the new replacement. Even though it's smaller, it's what's on the label that matters. And what we were looking for was, again, this little camera doesn't focus, so I'll read it off. 10 microfarad, 370 volt AC, plus or minus 6%, 60 cycles, 60 hertz, so 60 cycles per second. And what we got is exactly the same thing. 10 microfarad, plus or minus 6, 370 volt AC, 60 hertz, 50/60 hertz. Okay, so we can check that. So your meter should indicate 10 microfarad plus or minus 6. So let's quickly determine. Ten 6% of 10 is 6. So we want to be between 9.4 and 10.6. And if I turn this to capacitance, I'm getting 9.96, which is real close to 10 anyway, and it's well within the tolerances of 6%. So the capacitor is good, and I want to check that before I throw it in there and put all the sheet metal screws back on it and find out I got a bad part, you know, from the store. So that's it. Now we'll get ready to assemble this.